everyone, so apologies for my voice. I know I sound a little bit weird, but I have got a little bit of a cold. It's actually quite a bad cold, one of the worst ones I've had in ages, and I'm feeling a little bit better today, so apologies if my voice sounds ridiculous. But I wanted to come on here and talk to you about some kind of winter slash autumn skincare treats, because I've definitely been feeling that it's gotten cooler now and that my skin needs a little bit of kind of extra TLC when it gets cold. And I've kind of got a few autumn videos coming up. Hopefully, if I'm feeling well enough next week, I'll have some makeup, some kind of body care and that kind of thing, hair care, all up next week for you to kind of see. But today I'm going to talk to you about kind of winter slash autumn skincare products. So the first thing that I always like to do is I like to kind of use a balm or an oil cleanser instead of my regular cleansers that I've been using during the summer, just because I find like it's more nourishing for my skin, and especially when you're not very well as well, my skin can get a little bit red around the nose area and that kind of thing. So I wanted to use something that was a little bit more gentle. So I haven't ventured into balm cleansers just yet. I like to kind of wait till about December, January, when it's really cold to do that, when it's proper winter. But I have been using the Una Brennan Vitamin C Cleansing Oil. If you've watched my videos for a while, you'll know that I like this. I talk about this all the time, and you can see I've kind of used it up. It takes quite a while to get through oil cleansers, I find. I don't use this to remove my makeup, just because I find like it's quite a nice luxurious oil, so I just use it to cleanse my skin, give my skin a really nice facial massage, and this is really, really lovely. And it's got a really lovely scent as well. It's kind of, well, it was pointless of me talking to you about scents in this video, really, isn't it? Considering the fact that I can't smell anything because my nose is so bunged up. But the one thing I don't like is the packaging. I find the kind of spilly lid a bit annoying. But I like the kind of origin-inspired packaging of this. Then, in terms of kind of other skincare bits and bobs, I also like using kind of a serum or an oil on my face, because I feel like it just adds a little bit of moisture. Now, I don't use all of these products on a daily basis. Some I just kind of incorporate into my weekly routine, see how my skin's feeling. I am going to do an updated autumn skincare routine soon, so kind of keep your eyes out for that. But I do like to incorporate these into my skin sets 2-3 times a week and whenever it needs it. And this is the Aurelia Revitalize and Glow Serum. I've mentioned this before, and this is a really lovely brand. Their cleansing balm is really nice as well. But this is what the serum looks like. I love the packaging, again, the kind of little pipette applicator and everything. It's really kind of medicinal looking. And it's just a kind of creamy white serum. I'll put a little bit on the back of my hand and show you. And it really just helps to kind of make your skin look a little bit more alive and a little bit brighter. And you can see it right there. It's very watery, but it kind of just leaves a really nice glow to the skin. Makes your skin look really healthy and kind of lovely. And again, I'm smelling things. It's force of habit, but I can't smell anything anyway. So yeah, I went to work yesterday and I'd put some perfume on before I went. I bought the Jo Malone Earl Grey and Cucumber perfume, and I got in the car and my boyfriend said to me, "Oh, you smell really nice," and I was like, "Do I? I can't smell anything." So yeah, really been enjoying that. And then the Aromatherapy Associates Facial Oil. Now, can we just take a moment to say that I love everything the Aromatherapy Associates do. I've gone through so many of their bath oils. I love everything they do. I've yet to find a product from them that I didn't enjoy. I just think they're such a lovely brand. And this is the Nourishing Face Oil, and this is what it looks like. So it's just a kind of small bottle. It is quite expensive. It is quite an expensive brand. But if you're trying to treat your skin, this is lovely. And I don't use this all the time. I'll use it kind of 2 or 3 times a week. And I'll just spread it all over my face and really massage it in. I usually do it on kind of like face mask, pampanite type of thing. And I really, really enjoy using this. It smells gorgeous as well. And it's just really nice to treat your skin to that hit of moisture. And if you're like me and you have got combination oily skin, don't be afraid of using oil, because it really does work. It's not going to break you out. And it really helps, I find, to kind of balance the oil in your skin somehow. Then in terms of exfoliating products, I have been trying to kind of treat my skin a little bit more gently, because it's just been a little bit kind of sore and everything from kind of having a cold. And also when it gets cold, my skin can get a bit sensitive. And this is the I'm not sure how to pronounce it, microfoliant. And this is basically a dual action kind of exfoliator. So it also has little scrubby bits in, but very fine. And it also has chemical exfoliant in. So it really gives your skin a kind of smooth, kind of really nice resurfaced look, and it makes your skin look really glowy and lovely. So I've been enjoying that 2-3 times a week again. And then in terms of moisturizing products, I've got these two here from Rodial, and as you'll know, very expensive brand, and I've been testing them over the last few days, and I know a lot of the kind of really famous products are very, very expensive. These aren't kind of top of the range expensive, I don't think, but this is basically the Dragon's Blood Hyaluronic Moisturizer, and then the Dragon's Blood Hyaluronic Night Cream. The night cream has been too much for my skin, but I obviously am aware that it's kind of targeted more towards dry skin, so I wanted to include this for those of you out there who do have dry skin. But the Dragon's Blood Moisturizer is really lovely. Love the packaging of these. The color is just so gorgeous, and again, they did smell really nice, not that I can smell them now, but really just great moisturizer, SPF 15, and just works nicely under makeup. I am wearing it under my makeup today, and it just plumps your skin out a little bit. It makes everything look really alive, and you can get these from QVC, so I will put that in the info bar down below for you, but they are just great. It says here that they've got XXL plumping hydration, and it does kind of leave your skin with a nice kind of oomph to it, so I do like those. But as I said, the night cream was too rich for me. And then last but not least, lip balms. I do like to kind of really treat my lips to something moisturizing during the cooler months because they get so dry, and I've been enjoying the Body Shop Solid Oil, and this is in I think this is the Argan Oil range, but I'm not 100% sure. I keep doing this, I'm not learning, am I? But this is what it looks like. It's just a solid oil, and you can warm it up in your hands and kind of apply it to your lips, and it's really nice and moisturizing and feels really comfortable on the lips, and I've been enjoying using that. So that is it for my kind of autumn skincare change-ups. I kind of need to sneeze now. This was a hazard when making this video, let me tell you. So I'm going to go now. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you all in my next one. Bye!